Colin, and I'm going to read a book about Piper Green and the Fairy Tree. Chapter 1, The Important Stuff. There are two things you should know about Peekaboo Island. All the kids on the island ride aloft the road to school. There is a fairy tree in my yard. I have a lot of other things to tell you. My brother Eric said I should start with the most important stuff though. He is a 14 and very smart. If you don't like laughter, boats, or fairy trees, you should probably do something else. For example, you can go outside now and look for beetles. My little brother Leo likes to do that. He only eats the green ones. He says it tastes like a pecan. Chapter 2, Everyone Loves Monkeys. It was the first day of school. When I sat down to the table to eat breakfast, I was wearing a new orange shirt and a pair of white shorts. Also, I was wearing my earmuffs. They were green, and each muffs had a monkey face on it. Piper, Mom said, "Why are you wearing Eric's old earmuffs?" "I just feel like it." Leo kept staring at me as I ate. Then he said, "When are you going to take off that thing off your head?" "Never," I said. "Well, you can sleep without earmuffs on," Leo said. He's a year younger than me, but he is short and bossy. "Oh, yes, I can. How are you going to take a shower?" I asked. "I thought about it. I'll take baths," I said. "Who's going to want my friends with kids who wears monkey earmuffs all the time?" he asked. "People who love monkeys," I told him, "which is everyone." I tried not to look over the empty chair. It's a chair that Eric usually sits in. But my eyes have a mind of their own. They peeked it. It was the saddest looking empty chair I had ever seen. "Let's get a move on, you two," Mom said. "The boat won't wait for you if you're late." She had her book bags ready for us by the door. Our life jackets were there too. "Mine is an ugly old orange one. Ali O'Malley has a beautiful pink one with a polka dots all over it." We grabbed our stuff. Mom gave us each a kiss. Then they knelt down next to me and looked it right in the eyeballs. "You'll have to take the earmuffs off if Miss Gibbs tells you to," she said. "Oh, Miss Gibbs, only minds if you talk too much or if you put glue sticks up your nose. She doesn't care about kids wearing earmuffs." I wasn't 100% sure about this. I hoped it was true. Chapter 3. Glunky and Gibbs At the Peekaboo Island Harbor, Miss Grindle was standing on the wharf next to the Maddie Rose. The Maddie Rose is Mr. Grindle's lobster boat. Mr. Grindle takes us to school every day. Since only 8 kids live on Peekaboo Island, we don't have our own school. That's why we have to ride a Maddie Rose to the school on Mink Island. Good morning, Mr. Griddle said to us with a big smile. How's the wife and kids, Leo? Doing just fine, Mr. Griddle. Leo said. Leo tells everyone that they married. His wife named it Michelle, and she is a piece of paper. The children are 3 yellow post-it notes that he stuck on Michelle. Glad to hear it, Mr. Grindle said. And he patted Leo on the back. Then he looked at me. He squinched his eyes and tipped his head. Do you know, you have an awful lot of green hair growing out of your ears, he said to me. They're Eric's old earmuffs. I told him I gave them. He gave them to me before he left. Ah, said Mr. Griddle. Nodded. His face was serious. Today is a good day for earmuffs. They will keep the wind out of your ears. Leo and I went to the board of the Mary Rose. The first thing we did was go inside the wheelhouse. That is the little cabin where Mr. Griddle steers the boat. Most of the kids were already in there. They were sitting on the bench, munching on the donuts and talking. Leo Melly was there too. She was not wearing her pink life jacket with the white polka dots. She had a brand new one. This one was purple and had a mermaid swimming all over it. Piper, what on earth is your head? Leo Melly asked. There's many chapters. There's chapter 10. We'll read and stop at chapter 4 and read again next time. She talks just like someone's grandmother. It's a baked potato, I said. No, it's not, Ellie said, frowning. It's earmuffs with squirrel face on them. FYI, they're not square squirrels. I said, they're monkeys. Well, it's not winter, so you look silly, Ellie said. Yeah, well, you know what you look like, I said. You look like a bird, and Annie, that makes no sense. I can't look like both of them, Ellie said. Plus, I don't look like either of them. It's true, she doesn't. She's really, really pretty. I'll stop at the middle of chapter 3. And that's all for today. So bye.